2 minutes. Okay. So once we start to actually look at the company values and look at what they mean to us, we start the very important process of becoming emotionally connected to them. They stop being a poster on the wall and they start being something that we can take action on. Because until we define them for ourselves, we're not able to make pictures in our head of how we'd like to turn them into actions and how we'd like to express them. But once you get clear and you define it for yourself, you have the opportunity now to turn those values into verbs, put them into action in a more meaningful way that will bring you more fulfillment. So when people say, you know, we really want you to work with excellence, and you define it yourself, and you decide what that means for you, and you start doing it, you feel good because it is integrity. You become integrated. It's already aligning with what your internal definition of the word is. And so sometimes you see companies, they put their value statement and then they put 50 bullet points under it about what that means. Yeah? Which is actually, in my opinion, a huge mistake. And you know, and I just notice that Ericsson used to have bullet points and then they're taking them away. Why? They're doing that because when you impose your definition of the value on other people, it doesn't feel, it's not as easy to connect to them. It makes it harder to connect to them. And so when we do this work and we're you know, interviewing people and having people come in for interviews, why not, instead of telling them what the values are, why don't you ask them what the values are? Ask them what they mean to them, so that they can begin the deep connection to values right from the interview process. And now we're going to start putting it all together. So you've got in touch with your personal values in the first step, and then we created our legacy. And now we've looked at our definition of the company values, or you've made a list of your personal brand values, same thing. And now we're going to put it all together. And the way we put it all together is this, is we talk about how the company values support our legacy and how our personal values support and uplift our legacy. And when we do that, we start to integrate the whole thing into one thing that feels like us. And this is how you get people to be engaged in the value conversation. You give them a horizon to work towards, and you show them how their personal value and personal values and the company values support that vision. So we're going to do that now. So in groups of two, you're going to say how my personal value of, and you say whatever your value is, uplifts and supports my legacy is. And you see how your values uplift and support your legacy. So my highest value is growth, yeah? My highest value is growth, and that supports my legacy of uplifting millions of people because I'm continually developing my skills as a speaker and a coach. Does that make sense? And then you do the same thing for your three top three values. And then you ask, you say the same thing about the company values. How the company value of trust uplifts and supports my legacy is. And you talk about how the company value supports your legacy. The thing that you want to leave behind that's going to make that incredible impact on other people. So let's make a connection between them all. So in groups of two, I'd like you to stand up and do this. But before you do it, I want to tell you something really, really important. And there's a reason why I just sent you out for coffee to energize you. And that is that you have to do this with emotion. Emotion is the secret source of transformation. Because where there's no emotion, there's no connection. And where there's no connection, there's no commitment. Think about it. You go out on a date with someone. They're actually really beautiful. They look fantastic on that dating app. Not that I've ever been on one, but they look great on a dating app. My wife saved me from that. But you know, they look great and you meet this person, you've been chatting and it seems really good and you meet them and there's no chemistry. Zero. And now you've got like a whole meal you've got to get through together. It's going to be a long meal. I'm not that hungry today. I had a big lunch. So, but we can see that if there's no, you know, and then you don't have any connection to them, and so then you don't call it. Sorry, I lost your number. I don't know how you do it. I don't know how the cool way of doing that is. But where there's no emotion, there's no connection. And where there's no connection, there's no commitment. So if you want people to be connected to your company values, if you want them to be engaged, if you want that to be a part of your culture, you have to make them emotional about it. No emotion, no connection. So, when we're doing this exercise, I want you to say passionately what your legacy is. I don't want to hear my legacy, but I'm going to uplift and inspire people. I'm just tired thinking about it. So, I want you to use emotion. Whatever your legacy is, I want you to be passionate about it, and I want you to speak passionately when you're doing this exercise. So here are the questions, groups of two. I'm going to give you a good amount of time. I'm going to give you like almost 10 minutes to do this, all right? Because I want you to do it properly, because this is how we have the transformation today. So groups of two, work together. Please stand up when you do this.